What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of No Man's Sky. So as we left off last time, we were in space. I didn't know what I was doing. Yeah, and we went kind of like out of orbit a little bit. Yeah, I was doing like the booster. I was holding on space or whatever. So when I logged off, I thought I'd save the game, or I thought it would save us like out of space, but didn't. It saved us back at the planet with our ship. So now we're just kind of, I guess, in a low orbit. Can we turn around? Can we see the planet behind us? Oh man, this is awesome. All right, so there's the planet that we discovered. And I guess if we keep going down, we will land once again. I don't really want to do that. So we're in orbit around this planet right now. Guys, this is so awesome. Just being able to go out into space and just kind of fly around. What is this icon? That's a space station. It's going to take us 14 hours to get there. It seems like the HUD is a little jerky. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure where we're supposed to be going, where something nearby is. Anyway, let's go ahead and shoot one of these asteroids. All that stuff that we did last time when we got into space. Yeah, it's not here anymore. Yeah, I think we got some thamium 9 or thamium 9. I'm not sure how you say that, actually. by shooting some asteroids at the end of the last episode. Yeah, we don't have that anymore because, yeah, I didn't save. So we can destroy these asteroids. And I'm not sure what happens if we were to run into one. I assume something bad's going to happen. But I'm not entirely sure what. You know what I think we should do? Let's go to the space station. It says we'll arrive in 4 hours. I don't know how to get there faster. If we hold down the pulse engine. Okay, well, there we go. It looks like we have planets that are available for us to go to. Looks like we'll get to the space station in about a minute and 20 seconds. That seems like it's kind of a far distance away. I don't know how long our pulse engine is going to last. Yeah, because if we run out of fuel out in the middle of space, I don't know what happens. We have to like use our regular thrusters to get there, and we literally have to wait like 7 hours or however long it is. I don't know. But anyway, let's see if we can kind of point at the space station a little bit more. If I hold that, press space, W. Like, I don't know how this thing stops. I'm doing left and right clicks and stuff. I thought I knew how to do this before because it kind of stopped us at a certain point. But honestly, I don't know. I assume it's going to automatically stop us when we're in range of the space station. But it would be kind of cool to see, you know, what the space station has on it. So anyway, let's wait and see what happens so we get closer. All right, so it automatically stopped us. We're spinning around crazily. I don't know why. But there's our space station. Do we just fly inside here? Do we have auto controls? All right, well, it kind of like put me in there in the right spot. And it's landing on its own. Cool. All right, so we're in a space station now. All right. Restore point saved. So I guess if we die, we're gonna end up here again. So we have a door on this side. We have a door on that side. Well, can we run? All right, so we can sprint a little bit. Let's try and go up here. Let's see what is on the space station. It looks like there's not a whole lot here, right? We're the only ship, but it's got spots for like a bunch of other ships to land. All right, so locked door interact. We need Atlas Pass V1. But we don't have one of those, apparently. Okay, so that's fine. Can I use my thruster? All right. I didn't want to have to walk around and go down the little staircase or whatever, the ramp. All right, let's try the other door. Let's see what's on this one. Oh, look, another ship's coming in. Proceed to activate star system scan. All right, well, that's cool. There's other people that come to the space station. I guess that makes sense. Isotope interact. Oh, there's a dude here. Hey, Echo Analyst Entity Arivaki or something. I don't know. Let's interact. He said rare. I understood that. I know I can speak this guy's language. I honestly have no idea what he's saying. It says, as I approach the electronic life form, it instinctively starts to analyze me from head to foot. It chitters animatedly its head tilted to one side. The more it studies, the more the facility's resource vault consumes what my scanner suggests are silicate elements. I mime that I know little of its kind or how it communicates, and the lights in his mask flash. Okay, so we can give common silicate, we can give uncommon, or we can give rare. We only have the heridium. Let's give the heridium and see what happens. The electronic lifeform's lights flicker with mild disappointment. Nevertheless, it rests its hand on my visor and something. You have learned the Korvac's word for toxic. All right. I have to get a 20 carbon to interact. Journey milestone accomplished. Babbler. I learned 5 words. Okay. What you got on your little tablet there, guy? Uh-huh. That's cool. So is this... There's a thing I can interact with. So there's some carbon. I need 20 carbon to interact with them. Is there any more plants around here? Oh, it wants to give me 20 carbon. Is that... Okay, I can't do anything. It says inventory full. So we go back here, go to the starship... Actually, my exosuit, let's look at this real quick. Yeah, my exosuit is definitely full. So can I send like carbon back to the spaceship? Transfer. Maybe some plutonium. Some heridium. All right, so can I interact with you now? Request shield recharge, Korvac's point of interest or above. Oh, okay. So I guess we'll do the shield recharge. I guess, I don't know, is that good? Shield at maximum, all right, I guess that's good. I don't think we need to interact with that guy, but I'm still learning the game. We need an Atlas Pass V3 to get this way. All right, so how do we get out of here? Over there. Is this a door or is this just like a ventilation system? Looks like a ventilation system. All right, so let's go back out here. Is that other starship? Oh, there's like a bunch of ships that have landed now. Where are the people that are in the ships? I don't know. All right, so interact with this. What does this do? Oh, these are people that we can communicate with. I see. Make an offer on the lifeform starship, sell items to the lifeform, or we can buy items from the lifeform. What are you selling? Suspension fluid, zinc, iridium. A or D, I guess, a scroll to other. Okay, so we can buy plutonium or titanium. I see, so galactic average. I assume there's a way that we can sell stuff to this guy at a certain price. Either higher or lower than the going rate, so we can kind of barter and make better trades. Carate sheet. Cool. All right. Well, I think we're just going to get out of here. I mean, I assume talking to these people are things that we want to do, but I honestly don't know what I'm doing. Let's get back on our ship. All right. If we go to the starship's inventory, we have 3 inventory space remaining. Let's go and transfer, I don't know, like this plutonium or platinum, I guess is what that was, zinc and aluminum onto the ship. All right, so our inventory here is a little bit better. Cool. All right, so let's get out of here. Is it, no, not E, I think it was W. I think we have to press W to launch. All right, so now that we're out of there, I think it wanted us to press C to see the star system. Incoming signal detected. Okay, so we got another planet over here that we can go to. Let's go ahead and do our pulse engine. All right, so we'll be there in about 30 seconds. And here we go. Whoa, okay, I thought we were gonna run into the planet. I think we're going through the atmosphere. Are we okay? Okay. I think we're fine. So how do I land on the planet? I'm trying to point the ship down. There we go. Yeah, we definitely want to be able to land somewhere. I don't know where we should land at, though. Oh, it looks like there is some kind of a building here. Can I land on this? How do I stop? How do I put the ship down? I don't know. This is pretty cool, though. I do have to say, this is pretty cool. Press E to initiate landing. Oh, I didn't want to land down here, but we are down here now. Perfect landing. I'm a pro. Let's start by mining some of this stuff. I gotta remember what it is that we need to refuel. Actually, let's get back on the ship. I need to remember what it is that we need to refuel the pulse engines, I think, because we're almost out of fuel. Starship, pulse engine. I guess we didn't need to get in here to do this. So thamium 9 is what we need. Yeah, let's go and recharge it. How much? Okay, we have a little bit left. Oh, right, and we get this from destroying, like, asteroids and stuff in space, right? Cool. All right, so let's get out of here. There was a way... Oh, there's a sentinel or something. Are you cool? I think you're cool. All right. So, I'm going to do a little bit of exploring around here, see what we can discover, see if there's anything new or unique. We did see that there was, like, little buildings and stuff around, so I definitely want to check that out and see what we can find. Yeah, I think probably first step to try and get on top of one of these hills or something so we can kind of see. I might even move the ship and try and land in a better spot. But yeah, try and see what there is around here. Get out of here. See, there's a thing right there. That's the Heridium, right? Yeah, that's Heridium. Cool. So we found this stuff pretty quickly. I'm not sure how much of this we need, but anyway, I'm going to go ahead and just do a little bit of resource collecting. See if we can find some of those buildings. There's like a building over here. Let me finish collecting a little bit of this Heridium and we'll go check out these different points. All right, guys. Well, I just went ahead and got on the starship. I flew over here. Yeah, we got like a building with a beacon or some kind. And we got this little thing over here. It's got the question mark on it. Let's go ahead and check out what this is. Oh, we can save. Save point. Cool. All right. Picard Lowlands. Debris. Let's interact. Oh, I need an Atlas V1. So that seems like something we're going to need sometime soon. Just in pod. Okay. Did I get something from that? I'm not sure. Gek Charm. All right. So this building, is this anything that we should look at? Maybe this thing is something we should look at. Okay. One bypass ship required. We don't have one of those. What's inside here? Okay, so there's something. I don't know how to get in this building. Maybe it's in the back somehow. Cool. So what is this thing? I'm not sure. It's device shield at maximum. Okay, so shield recharge. First aid interact. Health at maximum. Analyze multi-tool. New technology discovered. Beam focus sigma. Faster mining beam processes on resource-rich materials. User will enjoy quicker element extraction from crystals, rocky outcrops, and planetary vegetation. That sounds pretty awesome. Sounds like we have everything that we need to build it. Is there a way that we build this, or is it already built? Do we have to do this? Oh, we can do a bolt caster. Okay. Beam focus. All right, so let's do this one. And then can we do this one, bolt caster? All right, so we got some other stuff going on here. So how do I use our multi-tool now? I can't do anything in here. I think we have to leave. Okay, so there's that. If I right click, scroll wheel. How do I change? I mean, the bolt caster is pretty awesome. Don't get me wrong. How do I change from bolt caster to the other thing though? There's gotta be a key. I'm gonna have to find this. Okay, so it looks like pressing X changes from mining beam, like we're using, to the bolt caster. And since we have the upgrade for the mining beam, we should be able to mine resources a little bit quicker. I think is what that was saying. So this looks like some kind of a deposit of some description right here. Let's go ahead. Oh, we got a milestone accomplished. What is this one? Sitting out, I traveled 5,000 U. I don't know what a U is. Can I mine this from this far away? Okay, so that is iridium. Is that faster? I'm not sure. What about if we switch over to the other mode? I assume this is some kind of attack mode. Probably not for mining. All right. What else do we have? There's other icons over here. That's a beacon. We probably want to go over there. So let's get into our ship. Let's see if we can get over to that beacon, and I'll meet you guys over there. All right, guys, we're almost to that beacon. We'll be there in about 2 seconds. Let's land. Cool. Restore points saved. That's what I like to see, so we don't end up dying and then having to restart. So what is this? Our cargo drop, we'll interact with that. All right, so we got a fascination bead. Okay, some plutonium, I like it. Oh, that restores our health, okay. Waypoint, interact. Navigational data received. Navigational data received, huh? Oh, I'm supposed to go over to that outpost now. All right, so we'll go from one place to another. Are any of these things stuff that we want? Atlas V1. Cool. Well, let's go over to the other location. Hello, Mr. Sentinel Robot thing. Don't mind me. I was just using the beacon. All right, yeah, let's get back in the ship. We'll go over to our new waypoint, and we'll be right back, guys. All right, guys, so here's the outpost. Let's go ahead and land. This seems about like a good spot. It's not going to make us actually land on that landing platform, is it? I hope not. Alright, I think we're good. Let's head over here. Is this anything we should be looking at? Cargo drop. Gek charm. My inventory's full. Alright, let's transfer some stuff back to the starship. I guess we can transfer the iridium. I don't really need that on me. Plutonium, that should stack, I think. More plutonium. A power canister increases capacity power gel source. Increased capacity power gel source. I'm not sure what this is used for. We'll just transfer it back. Okay, the ship is apparently full as well, so we're gonna have to start looking at dropping stuff or selling stuff. Okay, we can save here. All right, I'm good with this. So let's go inside this building. This is, I think, where we're supposed to go anyway. Does this do anything? Nope. All right, so this. I'll take some plutonium. That's cool. Oh, there's a dude. So we can interact with this device. Oh, I thought I was saying that this dude was a device. All right, so interface the entity. I cannot discern if the entity is flesh, machine, or both. Lights flicker across its visor, but it is motionless. Then its head nods mechanically just once towards a slate nearby. With a start, I realize that I can understand the text on it. I look to the entity for answers, but it remains still and silent. I suspect there is a mere courier not the author of the message. I suspect it is a mere courier. All right. The slate also contains a blueprint for a new technology, a hyperdrive. We did it. Let's take that blueprint. Instructions on how to traverse the stars. This will be invaluable. Calm blue lights us across the being's mask. And again, that goes too fast and I can't do it. I get an achievement, contact, hyperdrive. So in order to do this, we need a dynamic resonator, craft products, and inventory slots. All right, so we need one of those. We got plenty of heridium. That's cool. So how do I make one of those? Do I have to craft it on the starship inventory? Let's transfer, I don't know, transfer this back to me. Hyperdrive, so I need a dynamic resonator. How do I make one of those? I assume that's something we find. Do we have to go out searching for that? That might be what the case is, because I'm not seeing. I was thinking, yeah, that we'd be able to craft that, but I guess not. All right, well, I just walked over to the wall. Known, I met two aliens, so that's another milestone met. So I walked over to this wall, and I saw there was something on it, and this, like, display case just opened up. So it's a weapon terminal. We can interact. So it's a new multi-tool. It's got 8 slots. I think we're going to take it, right? Because it's got more slots available. I don't know. Let's compare. It requires 46,000 units. Let's see. Oh, I have 200 units. I don't think we can do that. I guess we're going to have to decline. I don't know what the differences are between them. If it's just like how many inventory slots they have or what. Yeah, I guess that's something that we could buy had we the credits, but we don't. Space station detected. So I wonder if that space station is where we're going to get our resonator thingy from. I can only imagine. Build hyperdrive, so it says return to our starship and travel to space station. Aha. Okay, so that's how this is going to go down. Let's kind of look at this other stuff real quick. Inventory full? Didn't I just transfer everything over to the starship? I guess not. Let's transfer that. This. That. Alright, health restored. We got another fascination bead. I guess that's something we need. I don't know. And shielding shard? Okay. Well, we're gonna have to figure out how to start selling stuff off. Because I don't think we can keep carrying everything with us. It's another one of these buildings over here. I wonder if this has anything of interest in it. I don't think we looked at this one, did we? Pretty sure we didn't. So what is in here? Okay, new technology discovered. Reload accelerant Sigma. Boltcaster companion unit. Boltcaster ammunition reloads times are decreased. Looks like we have everything that we need to build it. So that's kind of cool. I don't know if we want that just yet. We don't really have any other spots available. Yeah, we really don't have any other spots available. We're going to need another bolt caster or something a little bit better than what we have right now in order for that to really work. All right, let's go back to the ship. Let's go into space. Let's go to that space station. All right, so here we are in the proximity of this new space station. It says I've already discovered this, but this is where it said we needed to go. Oh, is there another space station that we needed to go to? I don't know if this is the right one or not. I see another marker on the map. Maybe it was the other one we needed to go to. So there's a space station 16. Oh no, is it this one? Yeah, I thought this was another one that was pointed to another space station just outside in space of this one, but I guess not. So we need to go over here. Let's go see where this waypoint is taking us. Oh, I can't run that. Can't run that long anyway. What is this? Galactic Trade Terminal. Welcome to the Galactic Trade Network. Don't copy my password, guys. Don't look at my password. Actually, my password isn't even there. Okay, so we can sell items from your inventory. We can buy items from the Galactic Trade Network. Let's sell items from our inventory. I think we're going to sell this emerald because this is just taking up space. So 366 for 99,464 units. Yes. All right, we're rich now. The fascination beads. I'm not sure what we need these for, but they're taking up space. Let's just get rid of them. Okay, is there anything else we can sell? We can sell some iron. The shield shard. Sell one for 100. I don't know what these things are used for. I can't imagine they're like that important. Anyway, if we go to D, does that do anything to us? We can sell the Gek charm too for 21,000. Let's do it. All right, so we're up to about 150,000. So can we buy power reservoir dynamic resonator? This is what we need. That costs 33,000. Perfect. Let's buy one. All right. So we made some money and we got the item that we needed. We should be able to craft it, right? If we go to our starship. Can we go, I don't know. I don't think we have an empty spot. Can we transfer this back to me? Click this, hyperdrive build. Awesome, all right. I kind of wanted this moved over here. I don't think we can move it. Can we do like transfer this? Now can we, oop, can we move this over here? The wrong one, it won't let me move this. Okay, so I need to collect a warp cell to charge up hyperdrive. Warp cell. Is there one over here that we can buy? Yeah, we kind of wanted like all the ship stuff, like the important things up at the top and like all the other junk towards the bottom, but it doesn't look like it can move those things around. So we need a warp cell. I don't see a warp cell. I see a power cell. Huh. Okay, well, I don't know where we're gonna get that warp cell. Maybe there's gonna be something, some kind of a quest or a new thing that will pop up that allow us to do that. It seems like when we needed to get the hyperdrive, the space station thing kind of appeared, so I can only imagine. Oh, here we go, here's another milestone. New business, I earned 99,066.4. Money maker. Then I earned another random amount. Okay. All right, guys. Well, I was kind of hoping that, you know, it would give us another quest. It kind of put a little waypoint somewhere. It'd be like, hey, go here to get your warp cell that you need. Unfortunately, that hasn't happened. So, yeah, we can charge this thing up, but we need the warp cells in order to do that. I don't think we have any. We can't, like, use any of this stuff. Yeah. So we're gonna have to try and find a warp cell. I did go and I looked in the terminal and there was not one there. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do. But I tell you guys what, I think we're gonna go and wrap the episode up here for today. Yeah, we're about a half an hour in with all the different edits and stuff like that through this video. Yeah, let me know down in the comments below if you guys have any tips or tricks or anything that I need to know or I should know about this game. But that's it for today. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time. Hope you guys are enjoying that No Man's Sky action. I know I am. This game is a lot of fun so far. Yeah, hit that like button, show your support for it. But that's it. See you next time, guys. Bye-bye.